to see you. I hope you're doing well. Thank you for joining me, and welcome to another episode of ASMR and Beer, where I do a humble, modest little novice beer tasting and beer review. Just for those of you that didn't know, that intro there was just my little take on the song Lateralus by the band Tool, which is a huge inspiration to me. Been a fan since back forever. It's really good to see you. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're taking one day at a time and trying to make the best of the good days and work through the bad ones. So we're going to be doing a little review of Stonefly India IPA. This is a brew that's a beer that's brewed right up in Kutztown, PA, which is north of where I live. I had was looking for some beer suggestions and couldn't find anything that were suggested, so this is the best I could do on a short notice. So we are going to, like I said, review that. I'm also going to take a look at some viewer mail from viewers, as well as some ASMR creators that were, you know, both of which were kind and generous to send me some mail. I'm not accepting any mail at this time, but I may consider it in the future. And it's actually about 10:30 at night. You may be able to hear the crickets and katydids. It's of course at the end of July, and they're really that more pronounced sound is the katydid. They kind of have longer legs than a cricket, and the crickets are more of a constant ringing sound. They don't really pause, or they're not quite as pronounced, anyway, as the katydid. So, let's feel free to join me, whether you have a beer. Let me know if you ever had this one. I haven't done a beer review in a while, just because I wasn't in the right mindset. I've had a beer or two over the last couple weeks or so, but that's about it. I always try to moderate. I just kind of, you know, I don't drink religiously. I don't make sure I have a drink every day. Just like my videos, I'm very ebb and flow, go with the flow. That's just, you know. So, Stonefly India Pale Ale, Saucony Creek Brewing Company out of Kutztown, PA, 12 ounces. This got a decent review, or decent rating of 83% on Beer Advocate, which I didn't look at first before I thought about purchasing this. I never had it before, and saw it was in my own hometown, so why not? Let's see what the ABV is on here. There's not 6.8%, so it's a little above average, but not too much. So it's an IPA. It has pictures of hops, people's hops looking symbol here. So I'm going to open this up. Couldn't find my one I use for the exercises, so I got it. Oh, this one, I can smell the hops already. This down before I play cards or look at the mail. Oh, it's got a nice hoppy with some citrus it smells like. So here's some bottle cap sounds. I know a lot of folks enjoy these particular sounds. Sharon. All right, let's give this a nice pour. That's not the best pour, but I do that mainly for the suds. Because I know a lot of folks, hopefully like yourself, enjoy the beer sud sounds. I know I do. This off. And it's definitely not filtered. You can see it's quite cloudy. It has a light, it looks like a typical IPA, but it's cloudy, so even with the condensation, the garage here is warm. Top that off. just gonna let you enjoy those beer sud sounds. Hopefully you can pick that up over the sounds of the background. All right, let's give this a nice little whiff here. So I'm getting a nice citrus scent. It's nice. My sniffer is never 100%, but I'm getting a nice, really pleasant aroma from this one. And we'll take a nice drink. So cheers from me to you. Lively. It's quite, it's not, I don't want to say it, hoppy. grapefruit. I think I'm getting some grapefruit. That kind of, I'm not sure if it's tart. I'm not sure if it's really bitter. It's smooth going down. I don't really have much of a bitter aftertaste. Yeah, nice grapefruit kind of citrus going. A little bit of bitters, but nothing that's too... No, I don't really like, I don't like beers that are really bitter. I don't know how else to describe what kinds they are, but this is... Yeah, that first drink, it's just so lively, just... a little tart. Like I said, the best way to describe it is grapefruit. Is that tart? That's the only way I can really describe it. Yeah. I like it. It's I'm not a huge fan of this kind of beer. I like more. I like more subtle flavor, smooth, rich, like a porter. I also like wheat beers, Belgian wheat beers, because they're kind of smooth. Some hops can be very hoppy, like this one a little bit. Now, I'm not an expert on hops and those types of beers. I'm not really an expert at of beers at all, of beer. This is really good. I would give this definitely above average. I like it. I don't know if I would pick it up again. Like to have all the time. Like I said, mostly because my type of beer is a porter. But it's definitely between 3.5 and 4 stars. I think it's really good. trying to taste what else is there. It kind of leaves a little bit of bitters on the palate, especially the sides of my tongue. I guess that's like where the tart is, the tart flavor. My vocabulary isn't the best because after a long day of grinding the gears away at work, and spending time with the family, getting around and doing this at 10 o'clock at night, most of my brain cells have checked out for the night. I like it. It's a good beer. All right. So we are going to move on to the viewer mail. And the main reason I opened up a box to do viewer mail is to make it more of a personal ASMR experience, not to for people to send me fan mail, not for that pretentious aspect. Look at me, I got mail. Because I know I get ASMR. ASMR is very personal for the most part. There's some things that aren't personal, watching somebody do a task, but it's a very, for me, it's personal. The triggers. But we've moved, so I can't, the box is too far away, so I closed it temporarily, but people have sent me mail, and I've been meaning to get around to doing this. I also kept the box open and moved away from doing viewer mail to this series called Letters from the Apocalypse, which is also on hold because my enthusiasm and my vision, it became repetitive and I didn't really like that. Kind of boring. And I want to reimagine that, but I don't know how yet, so anyway, I'll get to that. So I got a piece of mail here from a particular viewer who, by name of Colorblind Bowen, stand-up comedian. There's his little Twitter account. And he sent me that his all these little postcards and little stickers, grow a pair, that his friend does for him, beat the system. My kind of sense of humor. And squash the state. And this blows. And he wrote me a little, I'm not going to read it because he really say if I should or not, so I'm not going to, but he kind of wrote a little bit about himself and how he gets inspired and feels love and wants to pass it on, whether it's in art or talking with someone or being generous and all this stuff and talking about, you know, do we communicate enough and kind of paying the love forward through different deeds, whether it's making a PB&J for a friend, drawing a picture, and he thinks, you know, and he says that your mind will think that it's over, that you know, that you let the love go, and you know, is it gone forever? But then your mind, but then something happens, you get inspired again. And that ASMR, again, he agrees about the personal connection. He met someone who quoted him, Kurt Vonnegut, the most daring thing is to create stable communities in which the terrible disease of loneliness can be cured. And that's a great thing. And he just goes, and he goes on to write about a lot of different things. Just about how about the human mind and its experience and I don't want to read word for word, but. He took time to write me a message and send these little stickers in, and so I just wanted to say thank you, and please check him out, Colorblind Bowen. And I hope that your stand-up is doing well. And thank you very much. I'm sorry it took so long. I'm not sure if you're still a viewer or not, which is fine. You know, people come and go. That's fine. But your friend there is a nice little artist. And, you know, I just wanted to say that that's where I think when it comes to being a stand-up comedian or it comes to... being an artist, or whatever it is, I think in this day and age, this economic world that we live in, that you should try to find the thing that you're good at so that you don't have to work for someone the rest of your life, especially when jobs are just, you know, working anymore for a company is just not what it used to be. You know, they're not really dedicated to you. And you really, I really like to see people, love to see people do what they love and turn it into the thing that they can sustain, that will sustain, they can do to sustain themselves so they don't have to work for someone else all their lives. And if there's anything that I can stress, it's doing that so that, yeah, it may be tough, whatever business it might be. I know that becoming a chef, running a restaurant, is very stressful. Some people can't do it. I mean, if you're passionate about it, you know, so... But yeah, so thank you, and I'm sorry it took so long. I don't really know if you or he, if he's watching, wanted me to do a video on it, but I wanted to do that. So this next piece of mail is from a viewer called Hunter. Again, he wanted to just write about... some events that happened to him at the time that he wrote back in December of 2014. So I'm not sure, Hunter, if you're still watching. I apologize that it took so long. I just often feel that doing viewer mail, you know, people sending me mail and look at me, I got mail. I feel often self-conscious and that this may come across as pretentious, but I'm doing this for the sheer respect that you, by sending this piece of mail, and I wish I had more time to write back. I really do, and I hope one day I can. Time is my greatest enemy, besides my own mind. There's just work, family, and then the few hours I have left, here I am, 11 o'clock at night. just know that I appreciate the letter. So he writes in a little personal, and how he actually had to push himself kind of through it to get something done. Despair, and things like that. And he watched some ASMR videos to help him and things like that. And he sent me in this. This little knife that he carried around with him, or purchased. Just be careful, this thing's quite sharp. Hand forged in Texas by a bladesmith, Thomas Stuckey. It's made of D2 steel in the style of a Japanese kiridashi. While D2 has a relatively high corrosion resistance compared to other carbon steels, it still needs to be oiled occasionally to prevent rusting. So it hasn't rusted yet because I really don't use it too much. It is quite sharp. It comes in a very hard plastic here. Just gently. I'm not trying to ruin the blade at all. Just the tip, right, of the blade. So, thank you very much, Hunter. Sorry it took so long. My apologies. So as a sign of my gratitude, I've tried to incorporate this into various videos. So thank you. And I never expect anyone to send me anything, so. All right, we're getting into another piece of mail. From another viewer. And she just sent in took the time to print out some nature photos, macro photography of insects. I'll share these with you. This one is a daddy long legs. It's not a, I think daddy long legs is a term that's used for quite different types or one other couple types of spider species, but this is not a spider here in Pennsylvania, at least, or United States. We call them daddy long legs. These are actually an insect that actually feeds on dead plant matter and I think dead insects and things like that. So it's a nice, she was very kind to print out these and send them to me. Thank you very much. I love insects. Such amazing. This is a damselfly, related to the dragonfly species, but damselflies, one way you can tell the difference is when they are at rest, their wings rest along the horizontally with their body, I guess. When a dragonfly is at rest, its wings rest perpendicular to its body. So the dragonfly wings would be out here. They don't ever really close like this. I've taken some photographs myself. I may do a video in the future. So that's in one. This is what you hear tonight. This is a katydid. This is a katydid nymph. Nymph just means young. It's not really an adult insect. If you're ever interested in learning about bugs, just check out bugguide.net. 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 You'll find users. It's a nice little, somewhat of a community, but people just post their pictures there, asking what is this, whether, you know, from regular everyday layman people to people that actually have an interest, in scientific interest, and such. And then we have a little ladybug. Do you know that ladybugs, most of them are, or if not all of them, are male? I'm not sure if there's a certain percentage or what, but so thank you very much for sending those in. Nice photos, by the way. Thank you for those. I love insects. I've always loved insects and spiders, bugs, ever since I was a kid. A week ago, before this video, I drove 50 miles out of state to a particular forest that has a really nice accessible pond that has dragonflies and praying mantis. But I went during the midday when sun was out and they were just moving about and it was hot and nothing was going right really. So I got some footage, but not enough to make a video. And actually the last time I went there was about 10 years ago, when I first met my wife. So it's still there. I gotta go. I'm thinking about going within a few days of this video, early in the morning, when the sun hasn't really fully risen yet, because once the heat of the day starts to warm up the insects, because they need the warmth and the sun to be active. I want to try to get there while the air is still cool and the insects haven't really been too active, and I can try to sneak some pictures of while they're just, or video, while they're, you know, not so active. So, alright, moving on to another viewer. Sent me quite a few pieces. And nice bubble wrap. another viewer in here. Okay. I believe for the letters from the apocalypse, so I'll get to that in a minute. This one particular viewer. Sent in this little painted Corvus and Margaret with a Pink Floyd quote here. But you may feel a little sick. Okay, just a little pinprick. There'll be no more. She says, I dreamt about this scene. Figured you would love it. From a Pink Floyd fan to another. So, thank you very much. It's quite honored to have something from you. This is very surreal to me to think that, you know, I don't want to get in, you know, start to sound like I'm humble bragging, but. Thank you. And she also sent in this great little piece here. She says, in 2013, I was making you this, but my mind wasn't right, among other things. Her son got a hold of it, kind of destroyed it. And I'm glad he did, because I started over and love how it looks. My mind talks about being clear, and you know, watching ASMR videos has helped her and stuff, and all that. So, mad science, ears, freedom, all hail the, I don't know, different things here going on here. Bob Marley, Walking Dead, but it's pretty cool piece. So thank you very much. Thank you for sending this in. I gotta figure a way out how to. Pay you and everyone that's ever sent something in. So I know I talked about making some things available or photographed or autographed photos of different characters, and time is my greatest enemy. Anything? I think that's it. Oh, there's another piece here. Okay. Oh. Yeah, so she sent, drew this little here on a card and sent in a little card. It just goes on to talk about some things that she struggled with, and how ASMR videos has helped a lot. And I've been meaning to do an ASMR, like I said, have all these pieces in a viewer mail. I just finally getting around to them. I didn't have so many to do, but you know, I hear that a lot. I get personal messages on YouTube, mostly on Facebook, sometimes on comments about how ASMR videos really help folks, and it's just, It's just amazing. I mean, I don't mean just mine. I mean, there's plenty of folks that make ASMR videos. So everybody that makes ASMR videos, all my fellow creators, if any of you are watching, you're doing a great job. You know, don't ever stop being you. It's not a competition. We're not here to compete with one another. We're all here. I'm a community. So important to me. Community, friendship, peace, getting along. I sometimes feel that certain folks in the community are not as genuine as I think they should be. But anyway, the whole point is that this is something else, really. I'm not trying to say that the ASMR community is egotistically special, more special than music or anything like that, but it's own little special in its own right. This is a own little special thing going on here, creators. And I'm not going to say that we're changing. I don't want to be pretentious enough to say that we're changing the world and all this, but there is definitely something happening. I hear a lot about people getting sleep. And, you know, if it's a new form of meditation, a new way to calm down, a new tool for people to use to experience art or the human experience. I'm just in love with the human experience and trying to explore yourself and explore the world and enjoy almost every facet of everything that this world has to offer. And just, you should try to be a multifaceted diamond and not a lump of coal. So, thank you for sending those pieces in. I appreciate it. Okay. So there's another viewer. Where did I put it? She said she wanted to contribute to the things that I've done. Again, ASMR has helped her through some tough times. I think she is from Pennsylvania. And she sent in this little 3 pages. Which I think is for letters for the apocalypse. From the apocalypse. And so thank you. If you know who you are, Sophia Ryans is the name of the fictional character in this letter. Again, I haven't forgotten. Letters from the Apocalypse. It's on hold until I can reimagine it, because I didn't like the way it was just, it became a routine, and it, I don't mind routine, but I wasn't feeling it, and I don't really do anything if it's not from the heart, if I'm not totally into it, and so it, you know, it's not, I haven't abandoned it, but it's just on hold until I can get that spark, because the embers kind of died out, so I just need to get back to it, so I will. So I'm holding on to the letters. I've also thought about a website called Letters from the Apocalypse, like a community where people join. It's like a forum. People sign in and act. Everybody can just write almost almost like SCP website, but like Letters from the Apocalypse, and people write letters and continue and all this stuff. So my mind is there as well. So we'll see. Again, I have another from another viewer who really went out to create from the desk of Dr. Alistair Starks. He went out to contribute to the Letters from the Apocalypse and wrote some really detailed, lengthy stuff with some post-it notes stuff and a little letter. So, sir from Texas, thank you very much for your contribution. I will get to it. I'm hoping soon. So, thanks to all the viewers that have sent in your letters. I really appreciate it. It's quite an honor to receive something from you, and I hope that I can return the favor. I know you might say I don't have to, and these videos, and all that, but as I said before, I would like to do something in some way. In any case, we're going to move on to two viewers who also happen to be ASMR creators. And the first is PeacefulMind ASMR. I'm not sure if you're still watching. If you are watching, she wrote me a nice little letter. I gotta talk about Peaceful Mind ASMR. She is such a unique soul. And if you're watching this, I don't know where you came from. But I'm glad that you're here in the community. And I'm glad that you are who you are. And you're an inspiration to me as well. But Peaceful Mind ASMR, she's an old soul. Something, you'll have to excuse my eye, I got something in my eye. I had some issues I had taken care of. Anyway, nothing major. But Peaceful Mind ASMR, there's something very special. There's some people in this life. And I'm not doing this because of what she's done, although that's part of it. Well, there's some people in this life that are just these amazing sparks of light. They are light. I don't know how else to describe that. They're like this source of energy. And Peaceful Mind is one of those. She's sent me things in the mail for the Letters from the Apocalypse, and she's always been kind and graceful, just a great artist, too. She's the one that helped design the FM radio little logo, which I kind of want to make a t-shirt, but I kind of not really sure about that because I don't like the idea of making money off of someone else's art, even though I would split it with her. But she also sent this in. She's I love this kind of stuff. I love abstract art. I love this kind of chaotic, yet it's like organized chaos. I mean, just look at this eyeballs. She's got really nice shading going on. Corn, there's a tentacle, a stop sign. There's just a lot going on here. A little piggy. I guess that's Mr. Pigs, maybe, I don't know. There's the ball. There's blue, there's red. Queen of Hearts, and she just doodled this and sent it to me, and wrote her name on it, her Peaceful Mind ASMR in the back. So thank you. This is just, I'm humbled and I'm honored. Great art. I wish I could. This is the kind of stuff I like to draw. I don't really draw objects. I like to draw more just stuff like the tentacles and weird different shapes and things like that. Not necessarily objects so much. Weird creatures. But, so thank you. And definitely check out her channel if you haven't. Love to collaborate with her one day. She has a very great vision, creative vision, just a great artist and person, someone that you would definitely like to know, get to know and have in your life. And I'm not trying to single her out and make her any better or different. I'm just talking about her. So many other creators, out there as well. So thank you, Peaceful Mind, for your contributions to the community and for being who you are. So don't ever stop. All right. The last one is from what I believe is a fairly new ASMR creator. I'm not sure how long he's been around. But he is Wandering Whispers. And he created this mosaic. This is all tile. It's about 1/4 inch thick, some of the pieces. Put on this plaster board, whatever this is made out of. Put a clock, quartz clock, in it. I forgot to get a battery, but it definitely would work. Hopefully you can see that. That's amazing piece of art. It's Wandering Whispers. This is Corvus Clemens, the plague doctor. Thank you very much. He even put hangers so I can hang it up, which I will. But if you're watching and go and request something like this custom from Wandering Whispers, because he's got talent and I can see him easily doing this as a side or his main gig as an artist making some money selling his art. There's nothing wrong with that. It's the society we live in. This is great. Just in the fact of what it is. Not because it's necessarily, my character or anything like that. I'm just saying for the fact that he's got the talent to do this and put a clock in it. I can honestly see this kind of mosaic clock being, you know, him making them and selling them. And I actually wrote him. I said, you have to do this as a side gig or your main gig, because I can definitely see, you know, like a peace symbol in different shades of a color, and the background is a totally different other color in different shades. Or, you know, there's so many things that you can do with mosaic. So beautiful work of art. Check out his channel. All the links to these will be in the description of this video. And he also sent in a letter. But also a spy from the Bubble Boy Brigade, a spy potato. So now it's going rotten. There's reasons I just haven't been able to get around to doing a video with this yet, so I'm going to replace the potato, which is not really a big deal. I'll just keep the whole idea of it. So I have plans for that potato, Wandering Whisper, and anyone else that's watching. Alright, this video is very long. I'm not going, I don't have the wherewithal and mental fortitude at this point to continue doing solitaire or anything. So I'm gonna do this. I think I should just end it here. Viewer mail, keep this dedicated to those sent me a mail. And I want you to know, those of you that have written me, don't think that viewer mail is more important or anything like that. Anyone who ever contacts me, I want you to know that you have my deepest respect. I think, and I'm just doing this out of a little frustration, because people are so important. People's feelings are so important in how we treat one another, and I just, sometimes I get caught up in emotions and things, but I just wish that people just treat each other better. We treat animals better than we treat each other. I mean, I get animal welfare. All life on this planet is special, but humans, children, young adults, even adults, we're a little bit more special than animals, because you help out one person, and that person can help out others, and the others that they help can help out others, and so the results, the benefits of helping one person can compound. You help out an animal, it's not quite the same thing. That's not to say that animals should be abused or we can treat them however we want. No. But they are animals, and we can eat them and hunt them. I mean, they are a lower species. That's logic. That's common sense. You know, that's how we got this far in the first place, to even be able to have this kind of conversation about animal welfare, is because we've hunted and ate them for thousands of years, or tens of thousands, who knows, however long. We have to do it in a humane way, you know, as best as possible, but it doesn't seem like we treat one another, humans. I don't mean to get to a sobering note, but, you know, we need to do a much better job of how we treat. Human life is so valuable. So the human mind is such a fragile computer. So much power, yet so fragile. And we need to strive to make strides that includes me, and I'm not going to speak for you, but there's a lot of people out there that can do better. So anyway, I'm not going to be able to do the solitaire and peanuts. It's just, this video is long enough. I will do the next beer review, I promise, will be solitaire and peanuts. So, thank you for watching. Thanks those of you that have sent in mail. I appreciate it. I'm honored. I'm humbled. This is don't get blinded by the number of subscribers I have or how popular. None of that makes doesn't mean anything to me. I mean, I appreciate it. I do. All those that support me and have, you know, but don't think that I'm just like you. I'm no different. You know, I have my own interests, my own tastes, my own hobbies, my own passions, and just like you, and my own thoughts, and my own fears, and my own mistakes, and my own worries, and my own anxieties, and, you know, I'm human, and I'm just trying to live the human experience to its fullest potential, and learn from my mistakes, and each day. Now, I say something today, and I think about it the next day, you know, and was that a good thing to do, or that action that I took, was that a good action, and things like that, and, you know, and keep moving and trying to progress and improve. Every day is trying to improve upon past mistakes and choices, decisions, and things I've said. We need more peace in the world, and we need less violence and less shaming, less all that stuff. So, I don't want to keep going on, but thank you as always for your support and your kind words. And stay tuned for another video, whatever that might be next. I have no idea. We'll see when it comes out. Take care of yourself. Take one moment at a time. Be kind to one another. And until next time, tingle on. Bye-bye. I'm going to sneak just some peanuts here. I'm just a little bit hungry.